Hello. I am back to talk about Spider-Man Homecoming, the newest Spider-Man film. And as I've already said before on this channel, I enjoy comic book films. Batman's my favorite superhero comic book character. The Dark Knight trilogy is my favorite comic book films. I also enjoy Spider-Man. I've never talked about Spider-Man, never talked about the original Spider-Man trilogy, never talked about the two amazing Spider-Man films. I thought those were good, though the last films of both series kind of all over the place, particularly with villains. Like they had like one too many villains. But in this film, they have a villain we haven't seen before, the Vulture, played by Michael Keaton. And I'm also going to say, I can talk about like how the new Spider-Man, because Andrew Garfield's no longer Spider-Man. Tobey Maguire hasn't been Spider-Man since 2007, so for 10 years he hasn't been. I enjoyed watching Andrew Garfield. I thought he was good. I thought Tobey Maguire was good. But Tom Holland, he's really good as well. Though I've only seen this film. And he was in Captain America, Civil War, as an introduction to him, like this, hey, he's in the universe now. But, Sony owns Spider-Man, the rights to the film, and they try to always, I think they try to make this happen on its own. They wanted to make a third Amazing Spider-Man film, but for reasons that are stupid, and that never happened. One thing is, the people at the head of Sony, they canned Andrew Garfield because of jet lag, basically. He came to Brazil, I believe, to help promote the film. Spider-Man 2 or something. I don't remember what it was exactly, but he was supposed to be there to introduce this thing where they're going to announce him to be in Spider-Man, Amazing Spider-Man 3 and 4, and that but because of jet lag and how he was tired from, like, I believe he was in Los Angeles, he went from there to Brazil, he was really tired, so understandably wanted to sleep, but apparently this was offensive to the people of Sony and others involved, and it was decided he was fired. Stupid, but okay. But now we have a new Spider-Man, and as mentioned, the Vulture is in it, a villain that we have never seen on screen before, on the big screen at least. And Michael Keaton, known mostly for playing Batman. He's very good at being the villain. He's very good. I've seen some say he was even better as a villain than as he was as Batman, so that's something. Whether you agree with that statement or not, he was Batman twice. I think we'd have to probably I'd have to see him myself more as the Vulture to truly determine that assessment, but I can't see where someone would make that argument. He was very good. Robert Downey Jr. as Iron Man, since he kind of roped him in to this whole thing in Civil War. Yeah. Well, yeah, Spider-Man has a sidekick. Yeah, he has a friend. This dude. Can't think of his name off the, right now, but he is really there just for comic relief, kind of a stereotypical haha, funny friend. This one character who keeps appearing, she calls herself, at the spoiler, at the end of the movie, she calls herself MJ, though she's not Mary Jane. It's basically her first initial, the initials of her first name and last name. It's MJ. I believe they said Mary Jane will come in the sequel? Or at some point in the story. I don't know what that whole thing is. But apparently she's going to show up. And yeah, this is her. Yeah. Doesn't have red hair or anything, which is what you would assume for Mary Jane. So she's not a... Or she's not her. Marissa Tomei is Aunt May. She's a very young Aunt May. And she does a good job. She's always been a good actress. They don't have Uncle Ben, which I think is good. Excuse me, because, you know, we don't need to see the origin of Spider-Man over and over. They seem to do that with Batman all the time. You know, they did it with Tim Burton's Batman, which, okay, first Batman film on screen. Show that. And then they did it again in Batman Begins. Though that makes sense, because, you know, it's called Batman Begins. You need it. Show how Bruce Wayne became Batman. And they did that, the whole origin story there, and had his parents killed. Okay. Then in Batman vs. Superman, they did it again. It's like, we get it. We have two prominent movies already that shows Batman's parents getting killed right in front of him. Need to see this over and over with every new incarnation of Batman. I'm glad this broke that cycle of, because, you know, Amazing Spider-Man showed Uncle Ben getting shot before, you know, Tobey Maguire, they did that. Which, understandable. You know, I guess new series, gotta show that again. Okay, but we kind of have seen this before, but you know, this movie is like, we get the point. Uncle Ben's dead. We don't need to see it. I don't know if we ever will see it, but who knows. So yeah, I enjoyed Tom Holland as Spider-Man. He's doing well. He's doing a good job so far. But now we'll see. We'll see as this series goes on and being in the new MCU is going on. We'll see what his role is in all this. Since it is in that universe, I haven't seen. Well, I've seen that. I saw the trailer for the new Avengers movie. It didn't seem to me that Spider-Man's in this at all, but he, yeah. I am sorry. I can't stop yawning for some reason. But, you know, he is really good. I don't know if we will see Michael Keaton again. Don't know if he has it in his contract, if we will. Though it does set up potential people for future villains, or like one is the Scorpion. scorpion on his neck. Tattooed. So, you know, a sequel or so, you could, you know, you could see him as the villain. But we'll have to find out. It's going on 10 minutes now. I believe that's a good place to stop. Basically, just wanted to talk about me enjoying this film. It was very enjoyable. If you like Spider-Man, recommend it. If you like comic book movies, superhero films in general, recommend that. If you just like a fun movie to watch, just watch it, I'd say. It's not a bad film. Yeah, I think it's a good film. Maybe you will. Or maybe you won't like it. I don't know. Perhaps you've already seen it. And you've already made your decision. Alright, that's all I got to say. Until next time.